with rims, I don't want it. Stop me out, bit block me out. Robocop stay out, put my guns in the house. So much cash over this way, no drugs.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Stoners Anonymous podcast, season 1, episode 2. It's July 3rd, 2018.
11 p.m.
2 days into the L.A. Bron era. This is Kid 40. To my left, I have San Diego State Kawhi Leonard next to me. Say what up.
Yo, what's up? I'm Dominuke and Roland Fat Doinks over here, as always.
This is the biggest Kobe Bryant fan that you will ever probably know. Therefore, my name is Laker Fan 24, and you'll know more in a little bit.
Yo, what up? It's your boy T again, aka Blue Kodak, and I'm still coming at you with the facts.
So it's Slade, aka Nature Boat, rocking the D-Wave Miami Vice jersey. You know, hey. Team Heat.
Hell yeah, we obviously know what team you like.
Yes, since the first day I was in America and I learned about the NBA, bro.
Dwayne Wade,
that was my first favorite player. We got Ben Wallace.
We got a Kawhi Leonard fan, yeah, we got a vintage Dwayne Wade fan. Alright, I've been rocking with LeBron since I was a kid. Many people around, even in this circle will hate, especially the Kobe fans. I like their Laker Fan 24 over here.
No more.
Yep, but as you can see, we're gonna have to merge. We merged.
Dominic,
where's Kawhi gonna go, Dominic?
Kawhi, I don't know. I mean, with the Warriors doing what they did, or with DeMarcus Cousins doing what he did, I want Kawhi to go somewhere that's like really good, mm-hmm. so they could have at least a chance.
You want him to go to the East?
I feel like the best place for him would probably be the Celtics.
But he was saying he wanted to go to the Lakers. He already made that clear.
Yeah, I know.
I mean,
like, that'd be a good choice.
It's not up to him though.
Not for this year.
Paul George said the same thing. He said, "I'm going to the Lakers."
And he didn't say that though.
And then he signed a four-year deal, meaning he wants to live there for a period of time.
Well, Kawhi Leonard made it specifically clear that even though he has 1 year left on his contract, he's restricted this year. Next year, I feel like he's going to end up playing with LeBron.
But that's what he thinks right now.
Yeah. You never know. Exactly.
He might go to.
But he definitely does want to be in San Antonio.
Yeah,
that's clear.
If I was him, honestly, he gets traded to like the Sixers. That's a good team. You're in the East.
Sixers.
If he likes Philly, all of a sudden money.
The Bucks are developing too.
I wouldn't go to Milwaukee. Though. Fuck that. Yeah. I was him.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, it seems like he wants to play for a big market. That's why he's leaving San Antonio, I mean, right?
Philly's not bad.
Yeah.
Boston.
Philly. Yup.
Mm-hmm. Here's the problem with Kawhi. He's always been a quiet, laid back kind of dude.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, he wants to market his brand Where the hell is this coming from? He still
drives a 96
I think
Tahoe.
I mentioned to a few of you guys, like, his uncle became his agent and all this bullshit.
Well, yeah, I feel like I've been hearing a lot through like YouTube videos and like podcasts and stuff that like his family, or that they're calling it his camp, which is basically his family, is like telling him all this stuff like, oh, you're on Jordan, you need a bigger shoe deal, you need like your own shoe, you need to be in a big marketplace so you can blow up and get your name out there.
I mean, at the end of the day, can we even say they're bad for it? Because,
he's a top three player in the league. He should be marketing himself like that, right?
Respect just
because he's so quiet.
Because he's so quiet. So now they're just making him... They're not telling him to change who you are. They're just telling him, hey, go to the Lakers. You don't even have to be...
Just to get more exposure.
If you're with the Lakers, you're going to get way more.
Yeah.
And plus, he's like another LeBron, kind of. They're both really good defensively. When LeBron wants it, he can be really good defensively.
And he can be if he has Kawhi with him.
Yep, he'll take some of the pressure off, right? They got Kyle Kuzma, who's like 6'9".
Oh, yeah.
Play, put him at the four. But he can also run the floor, though.
Yeah.
For all these slower... All these slower fours are going to get wrecked by Kyle
Lonzo.
Kuzma. Yeah, and they got Rondo now.
Rondo, yeah.
Rondo lays us off.
They both can't.
The only problem is with Rondo, like,
yeah, I don't know.
He's as competitive as can be, and like, he wants minutes, like, especially if the postseason comes. Like, we all know playoff Rondo. Is Lonzo and LeVar gonna work with all that?
I don't. That's a good point, Jared.
I honestly thought both Lance and Rondo were kind of like bad pickups, because I feel like with LeBron, you want shooters.
You can't.
You want shooters. Maybe one of them, but to have both of them, both of them are kind of like, Lance Stevenson is a similar player, just bigger.
Either way, this is a really good defensive team.
Yeah. Like, it's a really good defensive team. Becomes a shooting guard. No. Because he's pretty tall for a point guard.
But the problem is he can't shoot. He's not a scorer. He's a passer. Just like Rondo.
Which is why that signing absolutely...
Yeah, they're gonna need some time. I don't know if they're going to start off really strong.
They'll probably start off like 8-8, just like the Miami days.
Yep. The first year in Miami, right?
Then they'll win 50-plus games. And people are like, we were crazy at the beginning of the year. Like, we were losing our damn minds.
But either way, the East is going to be a joke now. Anyone come out of the East now. Mm-hmm. And this is good. This is really good for Toronto, especially.
Pistons are going to make the playoffs.
It's good for Toronto. It's good for everybody
in the East.
Celtics, the Sixers, the Bucks. All these teams are going to be super competitive.
But now Toronto can give Lowry and DeRozan one more chance. You know,
dude, they had a good coach and they couldn't do it then. I feel like they can't do it now.
They can give it. Not give it one more chance for sure though, because LeBron's out.
Yeah, they might feel better.
He was the main wall that was in front of them.
Yeah,
but exactly. It's like you're that good, and to have legit one guy be the sole reason why you keep getting bounced
and swept.
Like, are you really that good? To be honest, I think they're mediocre. Are they really that good?
I think they're mediocre because they're like, in the East.
To some extent, it's like a mental thing. Like they know that like LeBron's gonna be so hard. He's beaten us 2 years in a row. Like they already just like psych themselves.
Who do they put on LeBron when they were playing?
OG Anunoby.
Yeah, OG Anunoby, Siakam. Like
Siakam. I don't know why they were even try that. OG Anunoby was the only guy that can physically like was similarly built.
Yeah.
So like Siakam. Dwayne Casey, I'm sorry, that was a dumb.
Like I'm not saying DeMar DeRozan could stop him.
Can't put one guy on him the whole game.
True. I understand that.
Can we get a put on him?
Yeah, that's true. They're not gonna put DeRozan in him and get in foul trouble. So
yeah.
Plus he can't guard him anyways.
Yeah.
I feel like all right, but if they weren't mentally strong enough to beat LeBron, you think they're gonna go to the finals and beat?
Hell no.
The Warriors or something.
But no one was gonna beat.
But
the Warriors.
But either way, Toronto was not gonna beat the Celtics. Because next year they got Gordon Hayward coming back. No. Jason Tatum's going to be more developed. Jalen Brown's going to be more developed. Kyrie's coming back.
Yeah.
They got Terry Rozier.
I will say one thing. If the Celtics were to get Kawhi with their coach and like how he runs
they actually
have a chance of beating.
Yeah, it would be
good. In my opinion, I think they'd probably still lose. But they'd have probably the best chance I've ever
won. Then if Lakers get Kawhi?
Well, that's different because you have LeBron.
Yeah,
early predictions. I got the Celtics and Sixers Eastern Conference, and Lakers Warriors Western Conference.
That's what everyone thinks at this moment.
And then Warriors Celtics, which could be a really good series. Cause
that'd be so fun. Because Curry could be a series.
Curry can't guard Kyrie.
And neither can Kyrie guard Curry. So I mean,
true, but
they're a pretty good team defensively. System wise.
But Kyrie doesn't have to guard. Either way, whoever guards Kyrie can't guard him.
Kyrie just has to stop the three.
I mean, Clay is pretty good on him, but he's not.
If you put Jaylen Brown on Curry, like.
Curry would get a tough 20 points per game. I agree with that. I absolutely agree with that.
I feel like Curry is not as much of a god as everyone thought he was for a season.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. He's kind of small.
Well, it showed against Houston in particular. Like, they were switching primarily to get him on every single ball handler.
Mm-hmm.
Like, James Harden crossed him up multiple times. You know, CP3 did a couple times. He got his revenge from a few years back.
Yeah.
Curry, he's not the greatest on-ball defender, but he wraps up the steals. He is a decent team defender. He does everything else so well, as we already know, that you don't have to worry about this.
This goes to what I was saying about them not proving anything if they win next year. And I think we're talking about Curry has 3 rings, 2 MVPs, and we're sitting here saying he's not really like a god or anything. Like, basically, because he went to the Warriors, and literally the Warriors play like in a way where you literally can't double team anyone, because they got KD now. So now they got DeMarcus. It's going to be even less pressure.
It started. They were good before
this. They were. No, yeah, they won 73 games and everything and all that, and he won MVP.
Clay was good, but...
But they were still beatable, though, because they did lose. This last year, they're unbeatable.
Yeah.
Not really, because they go to seven. Yeah, they did.
CP3 doesn't get injured. Yeah. I'm a huge Warriors fan, and they would have lost that series.
Yeah,
I believe they would have lost that series.
I'm hoping they did.
But we all know what occurred.
Trevor Ariza missed like 12. He was 0-for-12 of his threes.
Yeah,
missed 27.
But like, I really hate like when you say like it won't prove anything like. If they don't like if they win like
whose legacy does it improve? Whose legacy does it improve?
Their own individually. Like if you have three rings
if they blow through everyone, DeMarcus gets a ring this year. What does it mean?
That team is basically at this point like a free ring team. Like everyone's going to get a free ring. It's like I want a ring. I need to join this team for a year, get a ring, and I'll leave.
Yeah, DeMarcus,
literally, what's going on at this point?
That's literally what went through his mind. He was like, I want to take a huge pay cut just so I can get a ring before I get like old, because he just tore his ACL. You know,
yes,
he's gonna be out for a year. Done. Who knows if he'll be the same because he's so big.
Yeah,
and like leg injuries for people that are that big are really messed up.
Yeah, when is he coming back? Even
January. They said like January.
Yeah, so he's getting paid $5 million to sit on a winning team for like 6 months, and then
play for the last few months. Yeah, he knows he's not gonna play until half the year, but he wants to come back, get a ring real quick, and then just leave.
Exactly, because if he goes to the Lakers, he has to play from to actually, like.
I mean, it's his life. Honestly, I don't really care. Like,
and he knows he can't play the first half, so at that point, you're literally missing most of the game.
It would be fun to play on the Warriors if you're DeMarcus Cousins. Like, they have no big man. You can just come in. You can dominate like every like few games if you feel like it. If you're like, I'm gonna come in and score 40 today.
Because they'll let you too.
Because who's gonna double team him?
That's how they play. Like they play so.
But he's the biggest player in the league.
They're not really an ISO team. Like I know what they did with KD in the postseason, but like they moved the ball. All right,
but think about it.
DeMarcus Cousins. DeMarcus Cousins gonna have to get used to that.
He is like that. He averaged 5.5 assists last
year.
Yeah, bro.
Because, I mean, if he has
swear to God, he was
three shooters out on the three-point line, I don't think he's going to be like, oh, I have to take a shot. He's like, I'm just toss it out.
Bro, Jared. No, yeah.
He's going to kick out.
Because he's like, I'll know next ball like possession, I'll be back in the paint again with another chance.
Yeah, there's no way.
So it's going to be him trying to take a chance, and if he can't do it, he's going to pass out, get a three, and just... back to back.
I mean, I could see it where he doesn't like it though at the same time because he's not getting the ball enough. But I feel like if he doesn't,
he's this choice.
If you make the decision to join this team, you're probably a person.
But did he make this choice to go here because he wants the ball, or did he make it for a ring?
That's what I'm saying.
He wants the ring.
He wants the ring.
He'll play whatever.
Because he's already going to be out half the year.
Well, kid 40 said it's true. If I was a player, I'd want to play with a team like that. You don't have to try as hard. And you get to be good on both sides because you're not trying your fullest every play.
And to what you were saying, they had Rondo on their team who was like he was always trying to run like the play. He's always trying to do the thing. And you had DeMarcus Cousins running plays like averaging 5 assists when you got Rondo on your team.
Yeah,
he was shooting six threes a game.
Rondo,
DeMarcus,
yeah.
Jesus.
Hey, we lost the Warriors and be shooting threes out here like that. Like,
yeah, he's not gonna be shooting threes like that for the Warriors.
He doesn't need to. I mean, if he all right, wants
this
to,
is all right. Fine. This is gonna be like a really like cool year to watch, only because like we've never seen so many like cool players on the same team.
That's
like
true. This is like a
blacktop like team. Like
right there.
You make this shit on blacktop. Curry, Klay Thompson, like DeMarcus Cousins. You got Kevin Durant. Some shit like
We're getting real life blacktop teams out here.
Yeah. People on the podcast don't know.
It would be very discouraging as a player to be on a team that you lose all the time, especially when you're like one of the top players too. Like you're being called a top player and you're losing, so you know that's why probably him and KD went to the Warriors because at that point they just got.
I mean,
impressed.
See, like yeah, he. I feel like
I mean, come on,
making a good move, honestly, like with this like half year thing he did.
Yeah.
Like, see how like Melo missed out on his chance to get a ring. It's kind of over for him.
Unless
he takes a backseat role.
How like kind of like excited you get when you lose 8 games in a row to a team that just kill it, right?
Yeah.
You want at least want one win. Like you want at least like let me get at least one win.
Yeah, DeMarcus has been losing his whole career with Sacramento.
All right, so I have a question. What was a bigger pussy move, in you guys' opinion? KD to the Warriors or DeMarcus?
DeMarcus.
DeMarcus
100%.
Because DeMarcus, like...
Nope, I'm still saying KD.
Why?
Why?
Because, first of all, what we just said about DeMarcus, him being out half the year, and he took such a pay cut. He's making it obvious he's going for the ring. And second of all, KD is a better player than DeMarcus. Like, we all, like, if he stayed on the Thunder, he could have been, like, one of the greatest of all time. Like if he would have stayed there and showcased what he really had, like, his potential. But now he has to share that potential with Curry and Klay.
Yeah, and he still showed it off.
And he did show it off, but, like... He wanted with them.
I mean,
if he would have stayed,
still averaging 26 a game.
He's still shooting 55%
His arsenal of shots that he takes. How is?
Because
if he's not showing his full array of skills,
he can. No, he's here.
Think of it this way, Jared.
KD is the greatest scorer has ever played basketball.
Think of it this way, honestly. Though, because when he was in Thunder. Oh, I just forgot my train of thought. Damn, I had a good.
All right, I'll say what I have to say so you can remember. But KD's literally the greatest scorer ever, only because he's 7 feet tall, and he can literally just drive on you and rise up, and it's like you're not even there.
No one's there. Yeah.
He can literally just pick any spot on the court, be like, all right, I'm going to go there, I'm just going to rise up and score. Literally, he can do that. No one else has been able to do that.
KD on the Warriors, he's able to be very confident and just play. Because he knows if he fucks up, he has his team ready to be there and help him out. Any player there can just score enough points. And OKC, he had to be on his top of the game every single time. And when he's keep playing good and everyone else kind of playing as well, but he kind of got discouraged from that.
He was getting scared
because he's like, you know, I got passed. I got to play team ball. Cause
people aren't as competitive nowadays.
Yeah.
Listen, Jared, did he not choke
in game 6 and game 7 technically?
Against the Warriors. Did he not? Exactly. If he had not choked, don't you think he would have won the final that year?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, exactly, and that's what Dan is saying.
It
would have been that much better.
If you guys put the question like that, I don't like saying KD. You never have heard me say that KD is a bitch. But if you put the question in that fashion between KD and DeMarcus, then yes, KD is the answer. Like he made more of a bitch move.
Yeah, because he's such a better player, and that's why everyone's so hard on him, because he was such like a great player. Like he still is. Like he's probably better now than he was then. But we can't even see it because like. Well, we do see it, but you know, like if he was on the Thunder,
it would be a lot more like you see it a lot
crazy,
better
on
the Thunder because like,
and the NBA would have been evened out more. None of this would have happened.
He just signed.
That's the other thing.
He just signed a one-on-one. He signed for 1 year with an option. What if he leaves? What if they win next year? He leaves, goes to like the East. Goes to the Wizards or something.
The Cavs.
Oh, no, the Wizards.
He just goes to the Cavs, bro. They get the first overall pick draft. Somebody sweet KD.
Fuck the Cavs.
Bro, I'm thinking with Bobby if KD won a ring with the Cavs.
Yeah, the Lakers, Cavs, KD still wins.
Why you still fuck with the Cavs?
Who fucks with the Cavs? No, I don't fuck with the Cavs.
Why the fuck you say
I just feel like I feel like that storyline would just be crazy.
Yeah, that storyline would be crazy as fuck.
I can legit see him going to
DC
though. That's his hometown. So.
He has been signing one on one, and like he is saying, "Oh, I want to stay here." But what would you say? Like you're not gonna every year you're not gonna keep saying, "Oh, well, I'm gonna think about it." No one's here until one day.
Also,
like,
have you guys seen how all the fans don't even like respect him?
How so?
I saw a video like at their like one of like their parades.
Yeah,
and like the fans were just like basically saying like they didn't even need him to be here.
What the fuck?
They didn't really need him.
They ain't too cocky now because if he he played well, he could beat him. Like,
yeah, I
like,
don't
like,
even.
Show you, you're in that
like,
sweet.
Like I swear, you look like look
you're
it up.
Sweet, but
all right, that's like one fan though.
Houston could have beat him if they had KD.
I don't know. I feel like don't even like him like that.
Yeah, if Kevin Durant wasn't there against Houston. Golden State probably would have lost in 5.
Yeah.
I mean, Kevin Durant was that dude in the first.
Like before, Warriors were a little unfair, but they weren't that bad. Like, they're still beatable.
All
once
right.
KD joined, he, like, literally took him above that like threshold where it was like, you have to be on 100% of your game to actually beat this team. Because them and their bench is out here just playing like starters. Like, everyone there is like a starter basically at this point. Because like their bench can literally be an other team startup, or at least half of them could be.
Not as much this year.
Not as much this year, but like before they could. Like Livingston. I think he was good, but I don't know about you guys. I think Livingston played pretty well.
Yeah.
I mean, he didn't get that much time to play, so he can't really show off.
He's good, but
he
just said 1 point.
Oh, yeah.
All right, don't forget. All right, even this year, they still had a developing Patrick McCall who was like hurt. They got Jordan Bell, who's like super athletic.
Yeah.
They got a Finals MVP off the bench, Andre Iguodala, who still can like run plays. They got a veteran in
Divinity. He was named the rookie and was a second or third year player that unfortunately doesn't get any PT. I'm sorry.
No, that's what I'm saying. They're developing though.
That would have been an ass starting team this year.
No, I'm not saying they'd be a starting team. I'm saying their bench was is still going to be legit as they develop. They still have a crazy bench.
I was saying about like the bench being better than starters.
Lucky the Nets.
Maybe a year or two ago, but
the Nets might lose.
David West.
All right, the Suns will lose to them.
No. Nick Young
is the Suns would lose to them, bro.
The Suns are getting better.
The Suns would lose to them, Tyler. You
lose
to
them.
They got Trevor Ariza. All
right, bro.
DeAndre Ayton, Mikal Bridges.
All right, now they got DeAndre Ayton, bro.
What? Yeah, they got Ariza, damn.
If you look at the Western Conference this upcoming season, I said to someone the other day, I can see 14 teams getting at least 35 wins in the West. I can see 12 teams getting 45 plus wins. Like, that is how ridiculous the Western Conference is.
A few years ago, all 8 teams had 50 wins.
All of them, yeah.
They all had 50 wins. Which is kind of crazy.
We know the Lakers are getting in the postseason. Yeah. So someone's getting kicked out that got in this year.
Yeah.
I'm assuming maybe it's
Utah.
San Antonio.
Utah. San Antonio.
Oh, yeah.
The Mavs are
really
giving them 45 games.
They just got DeAndre. They still have,
he
is old, but they still have
DeAndre Jordan.
They still have Dennis Smith Jr., which he was pretty good last year. Now they have
Luka.
I'm excited to see him play, bro.
He's got DeAndre, so that's a pretty good squad. Honestly.
I'm excited to see him play. I don't know if he's going to be good, but
Luka Doncic.
Luka.
I feel like he's gonna be good enough.
It's the fact that he's a 6'8" like point guard, kind of. I just like that.
Yeah, he can shoot. He can play a shooting guard spot.
And
I'm excited to see Mo Bamba.
He went to. Do they still have Vucevic?
Yeah.
Why did they sign Bamba?
I don't know.
That was the
maybe they want to have like a twin tower thing.
In today's age.
Because Vucevic, true, but
do they really?
But Vucevic can still shoot though, so he's used to being like outside, like.
But do they really think AD and DeMarcus will translate in that same franchise? Because I don't see Bamba and Vucevic being AD and Boogie.
No, definitely not.
But like back to the question earlier about KD and Boogie. To be honest, like, the real answer is DeMarcus is more of a bitch because, you know, even though it doesn't matter what type of injury you have, this man averaged 11 and 5 last year.
Yeah.
If you even tear your ACL, like, your value does not go down. What was it? Like $30 million a year. Like, it doesn't go down that drastically.
For what? What'd you say?
This man would have been eligible had he not gotten injured for like a 5-year, $175 million deal.
Yeah, so what do you think his motive is? It's a ring. He already has money.
It does add on to his value with a ring now.
He just wants a ring, bro.
It still adds value.
Hey, if you think about it, he already has money. Like, he already has all the money he could probably want. Like, maybe he doesn't want like $200 million or like all that. Like, he already has like money. Like,
true.
This man, like, money's not an object to this man. He doesn't really care. He probably just wants a ring. He's going to be out half the year.
Like,
get
like,
a quick ring.
You
have some fun
NBA
playing
just
in LA.
For money. You go for the ring, too.
I mean, not LA. I'm sorry.
Because all that shit you have to do before NBA, like college, high school, all that shit you got to do. You do because you want to be someone in the NBA, not just going just for a quick check.
Well, with all the KD,
plus if you're that
then,
good,
with all the KD hate, then if you guys bring that point up, why is there so much KD hate? Because we all know, well, we don't know, of course, but we all know how hard it is to win an NBA championship. Yeah. So why all the hate for KD?
Because he's such a good player, and he could have done it on the Thunder.
Yeah. Could he have done it
and
on
they
the
were
Thunder?
Up, they were up 3-1.
He could have done it because he had done it before.
And let's not forget, he went to the finals before against LeBron, so it's not like he couldn't get to the finals. He got to the finals, lost in five because they were still really
young. He literally had a chance.
3-1 on the Warriors, and I would have been okay maybe if he stayed one more year, lost to the Warriors again in like five, and like we could see obviously they weren't good enough, and then he left. He gave it two chances, but he literally was up 3-1, then he just left.
Yeah.
He just left.
I fully understand, but like he had been in that organization for almost a decade.
I only hate on him so much because I think he's such a great player. Personally,
multiple conference finals. I mean,
yeah,
him and Westbrook and Harden did it. Got to the finals. I mean, mm-hmm. they had so many opportunities and they failed. How
and he
long?
Still had Westbrook. Westbrook
are you
was still getting
Dirk and Kobe and stay with the franchise for 20 years until it doesn't work. Like really, like.
But KD is better than Dirk, honestly.
Yeah,
and he's. He's not better than Kobe yet, but in terms of scoring and like pure like pure overpowering you, like in general, just like he's just better. like I said, he just can pull up from wherever. Personally, he's the top. Can we all agree LeBron's the best player in the league right now?
I agree.
Yeah.
Everyone agree with that? All right,
yes,
cool.
Second,
I have Kevin Durant. Second right now.
Third is up for debate.
Third out, I might have Kawhi.
I cannot put Kawhi in my top five.
Dude, really?
With this
James Harden for probably fourth.
Who would you put?
Who would you third?
Yeah, I would put Anthony Davis.
Ooh.
Anthony Davis.
That is a good one.
That is a good one, bro.
He's dominant as hell, bro.
This game.
He can dribble now too, bro. This game's getting kind of crazy. Like you have like 7-footers, like are quick as fuck.
Anything off the dribble nowadays. I mean,
yeah.
Absolutely. I mean, did
everyone's trying to be KD now. Everyone's trying to be KD, bro.
You guys
just pull up wherever you want to go.
Dude, remember when Boogie went down at first? The like next 10-game stretch to Anthony Davis.
Probably 50 a game.
Hell yeah!
This guy was averaging over 40 a game, over 15 boards a game.
Dominating.
I mean, 3+ blocks a game. I mean,
bro,
what more do you want?
Did you see like any of those games where like literally both of them would play and they would both get like 40?
Mm-hmm.
40 and like 15? Like,
yeah.
I'd be watching some of their games and like one of them would go off for like 10 minutes. And then they would go to the other one, the one that when AD got tired. And then they'd be just like unstoppable. You can't stop them.
Yeah.
They're just.
It's kind of fucked up though because did you see that thing on. There's a picture that's been floating around, and there's like a caption to it saying that like Anthony Davis wore DeMarcus Cousins' jersey in the All-Star game, and then he just fucking leaves him.
Yeah,
just to get a ring when they could have possibly done something.
Hey, so what do you guys think of LeBron going to the Lakers? They haven't even talked about that.
I mean, he could definitely take them pretty far, but I don't know. I don't know if he has what it takes to beat the Warriors. Yeah.
See, the thing is, okay, he played on a team in Cleveland that did not have any talent. And after after Kyrie left,
Kevin Love's pretty good.
I retract that statement.
Kevin Love's gonna go down.
When he wants to, he can average 20-10. The problem is when
20-10.
He's very
inconsistent. Why does he want to?
Because for whatever reason,
LeBron can make anybody. Hey, all right. Do you guys remember LeBron's last year, the first time in Cleveland, when they like supposedly were getting him players? He had Mo Williams averaging like 18 points, like starting, and they got him Antoine Jameson from the Wizards,
who
started averaging like he was averaging 19 and like 9, but like who remembers him? Because he was ass. He was just like Kevin Love, in my opinion. Like they're both like inconsistent and like. If you drive in and like kick it out, he's wide open. Yeah, he'll hit like a couple threes on a couple cuts. Like they just don't make like enough difference. Even though like the numbers aren't everything.
It's because he got skinnier and not as big.
The numbers aren't everything.
He was in Minnesota.
Yeah,
so you can't do shit in the post.
Yeah, Minnesota's having like 15 rebounds a game, bro.
It's because he was big.
Yeah,
it pretty much just goes to show, based on the contract that LeBron signed, that he pretty much straight up, in my opinion, didn't want to live in Cleveland at least, because mm-hmm. if you never, ever speak to Magic Johnson, who's the president of operations for the Lakers, and you never speak with anyone in the front office of Los Angeles, and you have a couple words with them after July 1st hits, and then you sign a four-year deal? Where is this coming from?
Yeah.
This doesn't come just out of the blue.
He made this decision really quick, didn't he? Hey, and Jared, I'll tell you, I honestly did think he would go to the Lakers, and I was kind of upset about it, even though, like, LeBron's, like, my favorite, like, still my favorite player, like, ever. I was just, like, I kind of, like, didn't want him to go to the Lakers, but, like, I'm okay with it. It's going to be, like, they're going to be, like, really good. Yeah. But, like, I knew he was going to leave Cleveland for sure, because he was super frustrated with that team.
Where did you want him to go to?
I kind of wish he would have stayed in the East, personally.
Yeah, I agree.
If he would have stayed in the East, they could have got, like, somebody else might have came to the East, too. I just kind of want to see, like, the conferences even out. Because, like you said, all these good Western Conference teams are not going to get in. And then you're going to have some really trash, like, because now the Cleveland's not going to make the playoffs next year. Who is ninth in the East this year?
I also saw a post about LeBron going to the Lakers that since he wants to make a big difference and stuff, like, LA has everything there. They have, like, all the movie studios. He can do whatever he needs to do. Like, he can literally... Business-wise, he can grow.
That was the other thing. Like this is his full potential. Like, why would you not want to go to the Lakers? I thought about it. Like, why would you not want to? Like, he already played in Cleveland. He went to Miami. He went back to Cleveland. Like... why not?
The other thing,
like DeMarcus, why not?
Was him enrolling his kids in school out there? Like, you're not gonna have your kids in Los Angeles going to school and then be in Philly or Cleveland, not with your kids. Like, I'm sorry,
that kind of gave it away.
Hey, Kevin Love in these finals, 21-13, 22-10, 20-13, and then. Game four, he got 13-9, but that was just one game. So the first three games, he was showing up. That's 21-12.
But did you watch the games though?
Yeah.
Did he seem like he's making a difference? Did he seem like he's making a difference, bro?
You say that, but he did make a difference.
Yeah, he was scoring.
All right, I want to see how many of those points were in, like, the first quarter.
That's still points.
But, like, when, like, it matters, like, that's when people remember, like, when you show up or not.
When it matters, it's important. The ball is in LeBron James.
When the game is close.
That's true. Think about it, like, literally you have a team where one guy can, like, LeBron literally controls the Cavs. Like, he has more control of the Cavs than anyone else in the Cavs, which as the owner does. Mm-hmm. So, in that case, he can get the ball whenever he wants to get the ball. So, if you have that kind of food, that kind of power, just listen to him.
There's a reason you don't question Kyrie left. That's part of the reason. Because it was LeBron James' team.
But yeah, if he didn't agree with it, then it didn't happen. Look what it was, and Kyrie's like, it's kind of bullshit.
And see,
I have other ideas too.
And I wish KD had Kyrie's mentality. Like, I'm gonna go to my, or Damian Lillard's mentality, where it's like, I'm gonna do this myself.
Yeah.
I don't want to be on LeBron's team. I'm gonna go to the Celtics, where they have a good young team coming up. I feel like I'd be a good piece there, and we're gonna try to beat him.
Yeah. Instead, he went to a team where he was like, I go here, guaranteed a ring, or at least way easier than another team.
Yeah. That's why Damian Lillard is really underrated for that reason. Just like his competitive spirit.
Damian Lillard is either about to not win a championship or give up and go to a super team.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Honestly, at this point, I think he should give up to a super team. Not now.
No.
But if he does it in the next 2-3 years, I think he should.
The only reason is because...
Think about it. If he's in doing 2-3 years, at that point, he knows that team isn't enough.
No, it's just because, like, now day and age, like the Warriors are just there. The Lakers are there. Like, and you just have to do it. Like, you're not going to beat him with the team you have now. Yeah. Like, you're just not going to win.
I feel like what's going to happen eventually is going to be a bunch of super teams where people just, like...
Which is fucked up.
Because all these rookies... Well, not really.
These rookies are good, though. Like,
they got to make more
super Marvin teams. Bagley goes...
They start joining each other. These teams might start being pretty sweet. It'd be like super teams, but like young super teams.
I feel like eventually, like, they're all gonna like even out. Like,
I just want to. All these new good talent, smaller market teams.
Well, not even like.
Yeah, but like if you were like super rich and you got all that money, why would you want to go to a small market team?
I know.
Why would you want to live there when you could just go to like live in like L.A. Literally do whatever you want.
But think about it with their mentality like nowadays. Imagine if we were all in the
NBA. I was trying to flex.
Imagine if we were all
in the NBA,
right?
So, you're not flexing fucking Wisconsin?
Yeah, you're not going to flex. No, right? You're not going to flex in Utah.
You're
going to
flex in, like, L.A. or Miami.
You're not flex in Utah.
That's where you flex. You can't flex in fucking Minnesota.
That's your personality.
No, I was saying,
so not everyone's like that, I guess.
Imagine if we were all just, like, because, like, these players started to be boys now, right? Yeah. Imagine if you just, like, hit up, like, all right, guys, we obviously are not good enough to go to the Lakers because we're, like, a younger team and shit. Why don't we just go to some small markets? Go, like,
the Pistons.
Let's go to the Pistons.
Yeah.
If you could do that, I feel like players are going to start just forming their own small teams.
Hey, let's not sleep on this draft class, though. Because this is a really good draft class.
What's
going to
be really sweet is when, like, last year's class
gets better.
Could leave.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure they signed, the first deal they signed is a two-year deal.
I think next year.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's
two with, like, an option, because I remember LeBron, like, he had his first 2 years and then he signed, like, another, like, 5-year or 6-year deal, and then he left after that. And that's why he was playing for so long.
I think a bunch of players that have only been there for 2 years have been leaving. I mean, we just got Glenn Robinson. Isn't he yet? That was his second year, right?
Glenn Robinson.
I don't think we had him last year.
Third year for at least 4 years.
Dude, I'm tweaking. But yeah, and these players can start. Hey, you guys know Dwight Howard on the Wizards?
They picked him up.
Yeah,
that happened today.
That's pretty good because they lost Gortat.
Yeah,
so they didn't need a big guy. Games were Howard. It's a pretty good big guy to get.
Beal and
Herbert. Yeah, bro.
I don't care what anyone. You know what I hate a lot? Like, when I go to the barbershop a lot, they always hate on Dwight Howard saying he's soft and whatnot.
Man, I still love Dwight
Howard. But this man is the first ballot Hall of Famer, right? And they think I'm BSing whenever I say that shit.
Hey, like, the one thing I will say for Dwight Howard is that there are only three players ever that have averaged a double-double their whole career. Like 10 points, at least 10 rebounds. And the other two are Bill Russell and Wilt Chamberlain. He's done it every year. No one else has done
every single year.
So, like, and last year he averaged like 12. Like, what did he average in, like, 16 and 12? And he looks kind of quick last year. He was, like, crossing, like, he crossed somebody over and, like, dunked on him. Like,
yeah, I feel like he just got super unlucky because he got hurt and then he went to the Lakers and all of a sudden people were like, oh, damn, like, he's on Lakers, he should do something. And then he just didn't.
He's kind of the Westbrook before Westbrook, because early in his career he used to rely only on athleticism.
Yeah.
And then he got hurt, so then now he has to, like, be like, damn, like, I can't mess. And he never had really an offensive game over there, but Westbrook has an offensive game, but he relies on athleticism a lot.
Definitely.
I mean, this man got to the finals with the Magic. I mean, the Magic.
Yeah, he did. Everyone forgets about that. I mean, they played the Lakers.
It took them to six, right?
Dude, the second game of that finals, literally, they were, like, there was point, like, 3 seconds left, and they alley-ooped it at the buzzer to Courtney Lee for, like, a game-winning, like, alley-oop layup.
Yeah,
and he missed a wide-open layup at the buzzer and went to OT, and they lost to the Lakers.
Shit.
And that literally was like, that literally would change, like, everything. It was crazy. I was like, damn, no, he just missed that layup.
Courtney Lee.
Oh, man.
You know where I messed that layup too, a year ago?
Yep. You missed a lot of points to win the game.
We still won the game, though.
We were trying so hard.
We still won the game. It was just, I couldn't finish that last point, bro. I was right behind
you. I was like, there's no reason to miss this layup.
I know. It was just me and this kid that, far from me chasing me, and I thought he was really.
And this
close.
Kid is like, this kid's like not big at all. Like,
nah, I was bodying the whole game.
Not athletic,
but like, I fucked up. Like, I started walking from the free throw line. At that point, I took a weird step. I fucked up, bro. Literally, what happened? I choked. I thought he was closer. I just I couldn't handle it.
At that point of the game, I was so fucking tired.
Same for the long ass game
for like a half hour straight. And, like, you just missed the game winner. I was like, God damn it, I have to play defense again.
Yeah.
Like, and it was somewhat close.
We won. Either way, we still won the series. It was just, I felt sad too, bro. I felt so fucking bad. I was like, wow. Like, literally, if I would just kept playing the way I played, I would have been fine. But I just kind of overthought it. I was like, shit, he's chasing me. I got to make it quick. I look back, he's far from me, and I was like, damn.
Just go to the Warriors. Do you want to overthink it?
Exactly, yeah.
You don't have to overthink anything. Missed a shot. We're still up like 63 points.
No. You need to take the last shot. Here's
KD. See, like, here's the reason why I think this is good for the league. Because I said this yesterday, I believe. And the reason it's good because, like, the Warriors are going to be favored in every single game that they play. What more motivation does an NBA player at that need? Like, they're going to give the Warriors 1,000% every single night.
Are they, bro?
But
are they, bro?
Yes, they will.
By the 40th game, if you see that they're blowing them out every single game, like, we look at the schedule, like, damn,
Are they really going?
If the Suns look at their schedule and see they're playing the Warriors next, bro.
Are they really going to...
They did that. They did it this regular season without trying. They're just going to do the same thing again.
Yeah, like... KD sat out like 10 games, bro, for no reason.
They tried.
For no reason.
They didn't try, but they would be up by 20. By the end of the third quarter,
It's always a third quarter.
And they just sit down. And they just be like, all right. Well, like, they literally have to try one quarter. Like, it would always... Most of their games, yeah. It would look like it was close for the first half, right? Like, oh, you know, this is going to be an entertaining game. They just come out... shit on them in the third quarter because they know, like, oh, if we're up by 20 by the end of the third, now they're the other team's gonna give up and we just sit on the bench,
bro. Imagine locking down KD, Curry, and DeMarcus Cousins, and then Klay Thompson's like 9 threes on you.
You bet every player on that court
like, damn,
would have to be
bro,
on the
like,
top of their defense, bro. They can't just fuck up.
Like, your switches have to be perfect.
Yeah.
They could be rotating the ball hella, bro. And then if you miss a rotation, DeMarcus Cousins is right in the paint, waiting to dunk on you, bro.
You have to play perfect defense.
And he can shoot. All five of them are going to be out on the perimeter passing the ball around.
One wrong step and point.
It's going to be fun to watch.
It's going to be one. The Warriors fan I am, like, it's not going to be that easy. Especially.
Really?
Especially. No. Okay, Houston, you guys are just dismissing Houston, dismissing OKC, and they're bringing everybody
OKC
back and adding pieces.
Yeah, bro.
The Lakers, you guys
I'm okay
are pretty
with
much
honestly,
dismissing the Lakers hey, with LeBron James. You got to eight straight finals.
Hey.
I'm dismissing them. I'm just being realistic.
Exactly.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, they will be a challenge to Warriors, but not enough of a challenge where they're going to win.
They're still going to win.
Because, like, okay, like, regular season, they might win regular season. Because regular season, you know,
they don't even need
no
to
team wins every game, but...
As long as they get in the playoffs, they don't even need to do... As long as they make it in the playoffs. And they literally, they could sit one player each game and they'd still be, like, a fifth seed.
And then postseason, bro, they could just actually go hard.
Houston
the Warriors. Oh, they could just
no,
sit.
Dude, they could still be a first seed. If they sit, like,
no,
a different player...
Shit.
They say a different player every day.
They
every
might
game.
Sit two players down.
That's literally what I was saying earlier. Remember, I was like, if three of them have a bad game, they can still win 50 games.
Yeah.
If they don't have a bad game every other game, they can still win 50 games.
Let me say this. DeMarcus won't be back until the start of 2019.
Right.
So
perfect.
It depends on how he... If he is even remotely close to DeMarcus Cousins that we all know and love, or hate for that matter.
I don't know if I love him.
Yeah, hate. Then, okay.
I don't hate it, but
I get exactly
listen,
what you're saying.
They,
but
if they were making it happen with JaVale McGee, with
Jim,
listen,
Kevon Looney, they even if he's ass, he's still gonna be so much better than all he lives.
He still has the size.
Hey, just his shooting and his size, just his shooting and size, and how he could run up and down the court, he could lose like everything. He can be slower now. He can not be able to jump as high. It doesn't matter. It's just him being like quick. And he can shoot. He's a big body. It's over.
Yeah.
He's gonna be an upgrade. He's gonna be
a part
upgrade.
Of the reason why I think Iguodala is starting more minutes because DeMarcus is so ass defensively. Like, he's garbage.
He is to start off the season, but
yeah.
Once DeMarcus comes back fully,
if he's playing with them, if you have, I feel like if, all right,
playing on a good team, he'll be motivated.
Like playing next to playing
he'll be having
everyone,
fun, bro. He's gonna be having
to,
fun.
Playing next to everyone is
better. Energy,
play defense.
Yeah.
What's his energy when you have fun, bro?
Yeah. Once he got the Warriors, he has so much more.
Yeah. If you're getting easy as bunkers, you're gonna run down the court on offense, trying to get more.
You have so much confidence. You got to think about he's gonna be.
Yeah,
crossing people, making shots. Like,
you're not going to be worried about your teammates fucking up ever.
Exactly.
Your Cousins. You're going to save all your energy like on offense if you're not getting the ball that possession, and use it on defense hopefully, because there's no more pressure on you.
That's how I feel. KD, why he's doing so much better than the Warriors now? Because he's
not that pressure. And I will say this is kind of good for the NBA, just because they've never had a team like this, and like watching them play some of the bad teams is going to be kind of entertaining, only because we can see their full, like, how good they can be. And second, if you guys have ever seen a Game of Zones, you know what Game of Zones is?
Yeah. I've seen a few episodes of
I've heard of it. The new season came out. I watched it. There was an episode about the Warriors, and literally Steve Kerr was like hitting like a blunt or something. And like and they were talking about like free agency moves, and like someone would come up, like Patrick Ma would come up and like tell them what happened, you know?
And they were like
Westbrook. I mean, they were like Paul George and Melo joined Westbrook, and like CP3 joined Harden.
I saw that video.
And he was like, "Hey, only tell us about shit that actually matters."
That's crazy. I've only seen like three of those videos, and that was one of them that I've seen.
That was a new season.
Yeah, I saw that.
So basically, that was last summer when they didn't even have Marcus Cousins.
Now they have him. Yeah. Now so if he's not playing with them, he's at least not playing against them.
House Warriors.
Hey, do you guys want to talk about any other free agency shit?
Who else is on the market? Hip on
who else is, well,
Tyreek Evans went to Indiana.
Indiana. Yeah. They might be a top three team in the East.
All right, who y'all got like set? Like,
I mean, the Wizards now are gonna be pretty good with Dwight. that's an upgrade from Gordon.
No,
unless he's still being a bitch and he wants the ball every time. But still, like, they could offer him that. Because
Ball
really
averages 11 assists a game.
Yeah.
So he'll be keeping spoon feeding them. Just like Martian Gortat complained about whatever reason.
I feel like the Sixers will be really good next year.
Joel Embiid is going to be a top
three center in the league already,
Denver,
bro.
You traded Wilson Chandler?
No, I said where?
To Philly.
Oh, really?
Oh yeah.
Wow, all right.
Yeah.
Will Barton resign to Philly? I'm sorry, to Denver. To Denver, sorry.
Jeff Green went to the Wizards, too.
He did,
He was like, I'm out of here, bro. LeBron's not here.
Like, yeah,
this
nah,
is why I came.
I don't want to be here.
Over under for the Cavs win set at 12.
Four.
Now everyone was saying, "Oh, Tyronn Lue can be the coach. Let's see what he can do. Let's see what Tyronn Lue can do."
Tyronn Lue is not going to do shit.
Let's see what he can do.
Fired like halfway through the season. They're not going to win shit.
It's very true, though.
He's not a good coach. LeBron was the coach of that team.
Yeah. Do you guys think LeBron's going to be a coach? He said he wants to own an NBA team.
Yeah.
Today.
I mean, yeah. He'll probably.
Absolutely. I mean, he can't. I don't think.
I don't know. He'd be a coach.
He'll be an owner.
He'd be an owner.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's definitely. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. He definitely.
You think he'll buy the Cavs? Lakers are probably expensive.
I think Magic will sell the LeBron Lakers, at least.
I don't think Magic owns the Lakers. Yeah, it's that one girl.
It's the Buss family.
It's that one dude that looks like that one.
No, he died. He died. It's the wife now. She
what?
Owns it.
Jeannie
Buss. Yeah, she owns the Lakers. Yeah.
That dude died?
Yeah, he died. Yeah, Jim Buss, right? Yeah, he died like 2 years ago, actually, I think.
Oh, shit.
I made so much off the Lakers, man. Being LA now with LeBron, that team, they'll be like selling out the first year at least.
But they're always selling out, bro.
Yeah, but like
the Lakers
hiked up $2,300. The lowest ticket prices jumped
$2,300. Damn, what? So like the nosebleed seats?
The nosebleeds jumped up
$2,300. So those costs like over
$2,310.
Wow.
That's fucked up.
Because LeBron came. It's the LeBron tax.
Yeah, dude, they're already taxing
for LA, bro.
LA, they had Lonzo shit last
all
year.
Every single celebrity you can think of would be at these Lakers games every single night. Unless you're going up against
Jack Nicholson.
Some ass NBA team like the Brooklyn Nets or some shit.
Hey, did you see
Regardless, they'll be there to watch LeBron. Nobody like
Jay-Z will go.
No, yeah, I feel like more people will go to the Nets game.
Going to your after party after, like,
if the Nets are coming to play the Warriors, like I would definitely go.
Yeah,
just
Jay-Z
to watch like everyone will go off. It's like damn, you just watched like Curry like 9 threes in a row. Like they're going to be dunking on everybody because they can't guard him. Like and then that's a double team. DeMarcus KD's wide open like every single play. Like Klay Thompson's doing shit.
One half of basketball though. That's the problem. Because you'll beat your ass.
Yeah, the rest of the game's gonna bench.
Nah, bro, they'll keep him in.
Just watch that like at a park, bro.
I don't know. It'll still be fun to watch.
At some point, the Warriors are gonna have.
I'm trying to beat traffic anyways.
The end of their bench on.
I know. I'd definitely go to the Kings. They're cheap. I would definitely say fucking go.
Hey, so the Pistons got Jose Calderon.
God damn it.
Luke Kennard got hurt in summer league. He's out for the whole summer league. We didn't even.
We got better coach too, though.
Hey, who do we miss out on this draft that we traded our pick for? Who did they got like someone like really good?
Wait, who did we trade our pick to? Clippers. They had two picks. They had the 12 and 13.
Yes. They got up. No, they got. I mean,
they picked.
God.
Some, they picked.
No, oh, they no.
Could've,
we got. I think they got. They got one dude from Michigan State.
Shea Gildress Alexander, and they got this one guy from BC who averaged 24 a game last year.
Hey,
Who was that guy?
I forgot what his name was, but he's an elite scorer, bro. Like,
damn,
bro.
I forgot. We had the Nuggets.
Michael Porter.
We could have got him.
To me, that is. The number two reason why I think the Denver Nuggets, if he is remote, close to even 100%, biggest steal or ultimately of all time,
Michael Porter
in the draft. Yeah, this man was the number one selection from all ESPN models and every model everywhere for like 5 straight years. Like when this guy comes
out.
Not
this year though. DeAndre Ayton was.
No. When I projected from years back, all the way up to like this year. Like,
I mean,
he was
that doesn't
dude.
Always translate though, because Andrew Wiggins was projected to go to number one since high school, and he did. And I'd say he's not like panning out. Like everyone thought he was going to be like LeBron in high school. He's not.
But
so, I don't
to
think that
have
pans out.
A guy like that drop that far.
To what, 7?
14. The last pick of the lottery. If he is anything like people say he would or could be. I mean, this guy, he said.
So why do you think they didn't pick him?
Something must have came out at the last minute, but at the same time, like, how does shit come out at the last minute like that on draft?
I guess we'll
night?
Find out later. Probably come out.
It doesn't make any sense.
I don't know. I feel like Jaren Jackson Jr., who's 6'11", and hit 8 threes yesterday in a summer league game.
I saw that.
And he had like 8 rebounds. Like,
yeah,
I feel like
the highest I saw his stat line.
Yep.
That's crazy.
Hey, don't forget, the Lakers drafted Moritz Wagner, too. From Michigan?
He got dunked on by Marvin Bagley.
Yeah, he did get dunked on. He's kind of soft, but...
Yeah, he got fucked up.
He's kind of soft, but they can develop him. He can shoot. He can shoot, and he's big.
Yeah, LeBron will do something with him.
Yeah. Yeah, LeBron, do you...
LeBron
Ball is about to, like, kill himself.
Do you really?
23-7 about Wagner last night.
Pretty good.
23-7 is pretty good.
Yeah.
23.
Could you imagine the sidelines in the Lakers?
Oh,
it'd be LeVar and LeBron arguing every fucking
game.
Yeah,
I feel like LeVar definitely does not have enough clout to be fucking with LeBron.
No.
So
hell
he's not
no.
going to do that.
Fuck
he, yeah, he could bench his kid if he wants to.
Yeah.
Coach LeBron.
he could trade his kid.
That's like call only LeBron.
Trade his kid, bro.
Yeah.
He could trade LeVar. He could ban him from the city, bro. It's over. LeVar can take his 2 points a game in college.
You said what?
His two. Remember? Didn't he average like 2 points a game when he played basketball?
Yeah,
that's
bad.
He doesn't have any say.
Undefeated, never lost.
They're paying LeBron $154 million. They're gonna take some of his advice.
No, he was on LeVar Ball's on CNN tonight.
For what?
They had him on Chris Cuomo, however the hell you say his last name. And he was saying, oh, LeBron and I have a good relationship, blah, 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 blah.
Bro, he probably
like,
has
okay.
not even spoke to
and
LeBron.
Then, and then the guy brought up, well, your team signed Rajon Rondo. How did your son feel about that? Oh, it's competition. Like, we enjoy competition. I'm like, if you don't shut the fuck up, man, like...
Why are they even asking this man for his opinion?
Dude.
Like, why are they just, like, giving him the clout?
Because he reacts like says, yeah.
He's just a strong enough personality.
And he literally knows that. Half the time he doesn't even think, like, the shit he says is true. He just says some bullshit. He's making money. They're paying him to be on CNN.
Yeah.
Who is?
CNN
is
paying
because
every time there's an interview, he gets paid for it.
Oh, hell yeah.
And if he's entertaining... They gotta pay him to fucking entertain.
Yeah.
I don't care if your actual opinion.
It's because what he says attracts so many different reactions
yeah.
and causes people to like talk about it.
It's a social media effect. Because he's a big star on social media. Yeah. Mm-hmm. The social media effect is crazy.
Yeah, so people go, LeVar Ball's me, he's gonna take some dumb shit.
He's a meme. Every time he goes out there, he's a meme.
Yeah, I mean, if he's getting paid for it, getting all this exposure.
He's a good stock.
You can't say he doesn't want his kids to be.
Oh, he definitely cares about kids that want to succeed.
He's making like a fool of himself.
The younger kid is fucking dumbass.
Yeah, the one that got caught stealing in China.
Yeah, is that the one that thought Leandro? Thought that Michigan was in Detroit.
Yeah, he thought Michigan was in
Detroit.
Yeah, that's LiAngelo.
No.
That was LaMelo.
No, that's LaMelo.
He plays for his like stupid ass like JV. Independent league.
Yeah, I saw he plays overseas, and like most of
he played for one season overseas in like some random ass country.
But I saw that most of his points were literally him cherry picking.
Yeah,
like he'll just cherry pick.
He scored
like
92 in high school.
Yeah,
it's fucked up. Yeah, he was committed to UCLA, but then they wanted to put a shoe out for him, so he just like tried to like make it on his own. So, because like you can't have a shoe in college, you can't like make money off anything in college. So he had to go to some like independent league or like another country's pro league.
Wasn't even
known. Well, what if you own your own shoe brand? Can you do it?
No,
you can't make any money. Like
you can't make money off.
You can't sign autographs.
Oh,
you can't sign autographs. Okay, you can't make any money off like anything. You have to be broke.
Bullshit.
Yeah, you can't sell any of your stuff to anyone.
That's pretty fucking
stupid. Like you know the Fab Five from like Western Michigan.
Yeah.
They would like literally walk by stores. Like I watched like a documentary, like and see their jersey and be like, I didn't make any money off this. Like I'm still like. I still don't have any like money. Like, they're selling their jerseys. Like
that's why they wore the blue shirts.
They still got free clothes and stuff from companies because you can still like give them gifts like that.
Yeah, but you know how much money they're missing out on.
I know.
Yeah. Like, free clothes isn't
like,
shit.
But I'm saying like it's so. You know,
how can they sell your jersey?
Yeah.
All
right, yeah.
Like how can they sell your jersey?
I know football is like kind of bigger and like, especially college, but I know someone that. He like went to UGA, University of Georgia.
Yeah, Georgia.
And he was the quarterback, so he was redshirting that year.
Yeah.
And they would literally give him like an allowance. So they give him I don't remember how much money they would give him. He told me it was like a pretty good amount of money, like more than a job, just like weekly. And then like if you need anything, he would just but like those programs are a lot bigger than most basketball.
Yeah.
Programs. Yeah.
Yeah.
They're
I'm sure it happens. Diehard. College football is really corrupt.
Yeah.
And college sports, NCAA is kind of corrupt in general. There's no way like, they pay recruits to like hookers and shit all the time.
Yeah. I'm pretty much to get them to go there for the day that Alabama is in the spotlight.
Really?
For
what do you think they're doing?
Something because
think they're that like,
they are getting
yeah they kind of are bro they're getting like the craziest players
we're
ever.
We're going away from the NBA talk for a few seconds, but. For Alabama to continuously get every single five-star recruit imaginable, I just don't understand it.
I'd be stressed out if I was other coaches. Like, what the
fuck? Definitely
have. I've been playing by the rules here.
Definitely have hookers.
Yeah. Wait, didn't Mark Ingram go to Alabama?
Yes.
And then after him, they got Derrick Henry, right?
Yes.
They keep getting these, like, bigger, like, running back. Like, Mark Ingram's, like, 5, like, 11, I want to say, like 220. He's still pretty big. Then you have Derrick Henry, who's like, have you seen them like next to each other? And then who is that other guy like after Derrick?
Didn't they have
who is that? You guys remember that? You remember the Jerome talking about?
Yeah.
He's like he was like twice as big as Derrick Henry. What's his name, bro? I saw a picture of like it was like.
Forget. Oh my god.
They had
fuck, bro. And he was like, yeah, I don't even remember his name.
Huge fucking running back.
Huge running back. Dude, Jared. Yeah, you have to remember his name, bro. I can't remember. It's whatever.
I'm about to look this shit.
Hey, the size of that team, I'm not going to say the skill, but the size of that team is NFL size.
Yeah.
Wonder if they're on
shit. Which is why I'm saying, like, how do they get all these players every time? Like, no one else has these players. They can't just, like, produce from Alabama. For some reason, like the hand just. Oh, Bo Scarborough.
Bro Scarborough. Yes, Scarborough.
That dude. Yeah. Hey, they don't know what we're talking about. Show them a picture. Yeah, you have to show them the specific picture. I'm about to find it.
Damn. Yeah, I'm not really hip on that.
You're about to be like, what?
College sports as much as...
No, not either.
I just don't have time. Like, I used to be, but then I had to start choosing what I did with my time more.
Yeah.
So I definitely gave up college sports.
Yeah, I follow college basketball a little bit. Just like, I only follow Michigan State, really.
I only watch the March Madness.
Yeah, I watch March Madness.
I don't watch like the regular season.
Did you pull up that picture?
You guys been watching soccer?
What's that?
The new World Cup?
I have not been watching really? The World Cup.
Damn. I have. I don't know.
I'm a Lakers fan.
Have you been, Jared?
You watch the England? Cups I've ever seen thus far. Like, it is absolutely sensational.
It is.
Every game is going to penalty kicks, bro.
I know, bro.
That's what I'm saying.
Bro,
did you see the England?
Did you see Russia, though?
England won, though.
No, England won, but, like, Colombia
took time. Dude, they had the craziest, like, the penalty kick. He literally, like, from Colombia, he just had to make it, basically. He just had to make it, and they would have been like basically like a would have won it. He literally just hit the crossbar. The goalie dove the other way. He just hit the crossbar, bro, and it went straight down and like out.
I didn't even see his shootout, bro.
I was like, no.
Hey, I'm about to pull it up.
Bro, did you see the Russia?
Russia against who?
Spain,
bro.
No, I didn't see that.
Bro, that the way that goalie Croatian blocked game. That for the win, that shit was crazy. He dove the wrong way, but his foot was tall enough to where his foot could reach it still. Damn. While diving the wrong way.
He just
hit it upwards. Just like barely just hit it.
Bro. I have been playing FIFA a lot lately.
I have too, bro.
Yeah, I'm really good at FIFA. I'll show both of you.
Bet.
Hey, man. Here are the sticks.
FIFA 18.
I haven't even played it
FIFA 18.
Dude, pull up.
All right.
Bro. I have PlayStation.
Me and my brother have been playing FIFA for the past 4 years. This dude just learned that circle is kick the goal.
Damn.
And not square. He kept hitting a square to make goals, and he kept obviously missing the squares to pass. He goes to me, I was trying to pass it to the goal.
What?
Like, you can't pass. You gotta kick that shit to the goal.
Right. I feel like if you were retarded, you would figure that out.
He just never figured it out, apparently. He scored before somehow. I don't get how he has.
Right, I'm watching the ball, this, it's highlights for this game.
England, Colombia? Hey. This is for the podcast. Oh! That was... He almost headed it in. The corner. Damn, they got a yellow card on a corner.
Oh.
Against Colombia.
This is when I started watching it.
Free penalty kick. Oh, that's kind of a cheap first goal, though, for England. It's kind of weak. It's kind of weak. Yep. What was he thinking there? Bacala. Oh.
Passed it back right there.
No. That was such a good shot for Colombia. Damn.
Oh.
Header in. The equalizer. In the 92nd minute.
Third minute of stoppage time.
That's crazy.
The 92nd minute. Extra
time is coming up. Yeah,
that
was crazy.
Yeah. Oh shit.
Yeah, crazy.
Hey,
damn, he's a
Spain next. So close. Colombia versus England will be decided by means of penalty kicks. Can
Henderson convert from the spot? No. The hush descends on the Spartak Stadium. Oh, that was it.
Wow. And Carlos Bacca denied by Pickford.
He's ready now, Dyer. Can he make it count? Yes! The goalie guessed right. England's penalty shootout jinx is over. England win
4-3 on penalties. Well, Croatia and Denmark.
Yeah, I saw that game too. Bro, Croatia's killing it.
Just the Russian. Spain penalty.
They haven't lost yet.
You probably shouldn't watch them.
Yeah,
they literally haven't lost.
It's just watching videos.
They're 4-0.
About that.
But yeah.
What do you mean? They could still hear it.
You're right.
Like, and I was still commentating.
You were commentating.
True.
Right. And they could still hear the video saying.
All right, here. Let's pick one more. Right. You said which one?
Russia and Spain. Bro, Serbia versus Switzerland. That's my favorite game just because. So the two players on the Switzerland team that made the goals to win the game were both Albanian. And Albania and Serbia, like, I got like a rivalry going on. So the fact that they made these like, points to beat them and knock them out was sweet.
That's
a bullshit goal, bro.
Can you even hit it?
Does he even hit it? Yeah, he...
It's a Russian player.
Yeah! What? Oh, this is a good shot. Both teams are just playing some pretty good defense, though.
Oh, yeah, he did hit it with his hands. Free kick. Oh.
This is pretty hype. Spain's got an ass now. Damn.
Bro. Not sad. Penalty kicks again. Oh!
Boy.
Russia.
And now they have to.
They have to make it.
Boy.
Bro, he just like airballed that. He literally airballed that.
Bro.
He kicks it. What do you mean?
Yeah.
The goalie.
Oh, wait. That's that was not talking about air, man, bro. I forgot. I fucked up.
Damn, dude.
Damn, imagine that, bro. Fuck. Like, your whole country is watching. You just miss.
The best game, though, from this World Cup was Belgium versus Japan.
I was about to say, that goal, that last goal was fucking
that
ridiculous.
That last goal.
What happened?
Goalie, it was the 4th minute of stoppage time. The goalie had just grabbed the ball from the net. He rolled it out to one of his players, and they just went running down the pitch.
So synchronized.
Running down the pitch. And, oh my god, he got all the way down there. It was like 3-on-2 or whatever it was. Pass it back. Left side. Goal.
Damn.
Into the 5th minute of stoppage time. It was ridiculous.
It was literally the last play of the game.
Yeah, the shit.
It was crazy, though, how like, a lot of the really good teams that are generically in like the last few rounds are now out. Like, Germany's out. Spain's out. Portugal's out.
Yeah, because the World Cup's every 4 years. Like, you realize, like, these players age, like,
yeah.
But if people still age 4 years, though, they, like, you're not going to be as good.
Unlike the finals.
You say that, but Messi and...
They're still, like, 30.
Have been good for, like... They've been the best players by far.
They're not as old as you think. They're both, like 29. This is, like... They're good in their other leagues.
Dude,
there's, like, an NBA for soccer, you know?
Yeah,
there's, like, Euro League. So,
yeah, there's a league. Ronaldo...
He's still like 29,
he's
but he's
33.
But who's younger? Is Messi like the...
Most athletes, they retire at like close to 40. If not 40.
And soccer, you don't really...
Plus soccer, you just...
When do you
running.
Start?
And there's no contact.
How many miles have you put on your body?
No, that is true. But I mean, so like running isn't as bad as literally bodily hits. Because like running, you're just conditioning your heart. But when you're like football, when you're hitting each other hard,
football is not comparable to anything though. Yeah. You're literally like
basketball when you're jumping a lot and like yourself. It's not a quick movement. Soccer is long distance mostly than quicker movements, like basketball. Because basketball is
literally still
sport that you're like
movements.
You do. Messing you don't.
And sprinting
but, like, in,
too.
In basketball, it's really small course, so you're like a lot of quick movements, a lot plus a lot of jumping.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You gotta be so conditioned to play soccer.
So yeah, so I'm not saying soccer doesn't injure you, but not as bigger injuries as you see these other sports.
All right, it's not football.
Yeah,
it's not football, but it's not baseball.
Yeah, no, it's definitely not baseball. Baseball, you can play until like 70, bro. You can just
like. You got Bartolo Colon pitching. He's like.
You gotta be in shape.
Bro, that dude's
baseball.
Like 65.
Or NHL goalie. Those dudes, I'll just see like a, like, oh, a 46-year-old.
No,
like,
they get some fucked up knees.
Yeah. No, from, like, you, squatting you, all the time. You're like this, bro. Like, you're, it's not good shape.
But I just, like, old ass. Like, well, like, why are NHL contracts so long? Like,
they always get, like,
a 10-year deal.
They always get, like, groin injuries, too. I didn't know, from, like, splitting all the time just to save goals.
Yeah, but that's
like, they do a lot of weird movement, and it has to be super quick. So they
But if you're flexible as hell, like,
you probably pull a lot of muscles in the legs, too.
Yeah, yeah. They get a lot of groin injuries.
What's the longest contract?
Bro, I'm about to look up the oldest NHL players like play, bro.
I don't really know.
The longest contract were probably over 10 years.
No.
Shit.
No.
Yeah. What?
No, I don't think Jared. I don't think it's that.
Jared, back me up. Bad connection this
Come
moment,
on, Lakers fans.
Let me pull up.
Just offhand that 8 to 10 years, or what I've seen.
Yeah, see. Hear what I'm saying.
That's crazy.
Wow.
It's like you're really going
don't these players get the shit beat out of them?
That's yeah. They take so much abuse.
How much money do they make in those 8 to 10
years? It's not as much.
Not that much.
It's less than NBA.
Way less, yeah.
Because NHL...
NBA is ridiculous now. NBA is...
Soccer is ridiculous, too. At least in Europe, it is.
Baseball is pretty
baseball
crazy, too.
Baseball is the most ridiculous because there is no cap.
There's no cap in baseball.
Zero cap.
No cap.
What's the cap in the NBA?
It's pretty high now.
I can see, man. 154,000. Million.
Mike Conley got more emotional.
Right. What's the easy to get paid?
You remember that weird moment he was the highest paid player in the league?
Yeah.
Highest paid player?
A longest contract in NHL ice hockey, originally signed by Rick DiPietro. 15 years.
15?
What?
Oh my god. How much did he get?
It's basically a career. You're close to a career.
Said it was later matched by some guy. I got signed to the New Jersey Devils 2010 for 15 years.
Bro. Wait, in 2010?
Yeah.
So he's like halfway done now.
So 2025.
How old is this guy now? Like, look him up. How old is he now? Like, or look up the oldest NHL active player.
Yeah.
Active NHL player.
Wait, so can you retire before 15 years? If, like,
yeah, I'm sure you
I think you
can retire whatever you want. They can't force you to,
like,
play.
Yeah, if he's like getting just super injured, they're not gonna make him play. Like, alright man, you gotta get back.
They're kinda dumb.
You got 6 more years.
They're kinda dumb for signing people to that long of a deal in a sport that's so violent.
The oldest person
it was Jagr.
Yeah, he's 45
right now.
23 seasons.
45? What is he, a goalie?
No,
he's not a goalie.
Alright, what about this guy? I wonder if he's still even playing. Kovalchuk.
He might be Russian.
Discount double check.
Yeah, the discount double check.
Yeah.
Yeah, sweet name. Name I kid. Discount double check. Alright. Okay, he's still playing, but he's with a different team now. He's 35 right now, so he's going to be playing. His contract is to be like 42.
Jesus Christ.
He's literally played a whole career.
How are you so confident in someone? How?
I mean, I guess they get traded. There's probably more trades. So.
Way more loyal and hockey than the NBA, I'll tell you that.
A lot.
Are they actually?
Yeah,
I mean, if they're like 8 to 15 year contracts, like, it's pretty loyal.
I'm gonna live my next 15 years.
Boogie said, I feel you, but
Boogie said 1 year to the Warriors, and it's basically 6 months to the Warriors. Why play for the first half of the year?
Rajon Rondo being a Boston, a so-called Boston guy for life, he signs with the Lakers.
He signed with what was the team before?
Yeah,
Lakers?
Well, no, no, I'm
yeah,
saying
with
he signed with Pelicans.
That's what I'm saying. The competitive
jumping.
I'm just saying. You're saying Celtics Lakers, like, he's supposed to be Celtic for life, and now he's just joined LeBron. Who was his
nemesis?
Nemesis for all those years.
And with
bro.
The Lakers.
That's what I'm saying.
Celtic for life. Like,
that's
yeah,
what I'm saying.
I'm not give a shit.
DeMarcus doesn't have the competitive spirit. KD doesn't have the competitive spirit.
No,
Rondo.
I don't know.
Like,
no, he does.
Rivalries don't really. What rivalries are there like now? Like in the NBA.
Personal. Not really. Like, yeah. I feel like I don't know. I feel like if we lived,
people
like,
don't go after each other, bro.
Players. I think if I lived in the '90s, watching the NBA would kind of be sweeter in the Everyone hated each other.
Would it really be? Because we all know what the result was.
In a different way, though.
Hey, but Jared, but think about it.
Everyone was so competitive, and they were so sweet. Jordan shit, bro. He won all the time, but, like, it was people, like, everyone just tried really hard.
Hey, at least Jordan played, like, teams. A different team, though. Yeah, everyone was on played different teams. And also, if you did watch it back then, you wouldn't know about players today. So yeah, the players you'd be watching, you would think were the best, like, ever. Especially when you compare them to the era before, which was, like the 70s. You'd be like, damn, these players are sweet as fuck. Like,
yeah.
Jordan from the free throw line, that was, like, never seen. Like,
same thing with this era, too.
Yeah, and next era, maybe will be... I don't know how much farther they can go from this.
We keep feeding these children McDonald's, and they're going to get fucking out of control.
Duck it from the three-point line.
Hell yeah, bro. They're going to be so fucking athletic. Pumping them with hella hormones.
It's going to be a bunch of seven-footers, like shooting really quick.
Like, seven-footer shooting from the logo.
A bunch of Giannis seven. And the Kumpels.
Yeah, and Kevin Durant. Hopefully, that would be like really. That would be like.
It'd be pretty entertaining. It'd become like just Giants, basically. LB is struggling with his charger. Bleep.
Bleep.
Are we?
Nature Boat is struggling with his charger.
It's cool. Like, we've all said each other's names at least once this podcast.
No, it's still. We're still on.
How long?
Kid 40.
We're
an hour and
16
minutes.
Yeah.
12:11. You
want to
wrap it up?
Yeah, I think we're. I think we talked about a lot.
We did, yeah.
We definitely had a good.
We probably should call it the NBA podcast, though. We talked mostly about NBA, though.
Yeah, we did.
We kept it on topic. It doesn't.
We were like ESPN, but we had some highlights. We came out with soccer a little bit, you know. Like, yeah, we had. But they mostly cover basketball, you know. Like,
yeah. It started on basketball.
They'll show you a couple games. Yeah, soccer games.
We did that first take where it is all NBA, and then you have a little bit of deep bullshit here about other sports. But yeah, we just had a Stephen A. Smith and Matt Kellerman debate expanded.
Hey, did you guys? All right, do you guys like Max? Do you guys like Max?
No,
MacBooks.
Not really.
Max Kellerman.
Yeah, Max. Oh my bad.
I like he plays it safe too often. In my opinion, because he doesn't want everyone to outrage. Like Stephen A. will say whatever he wants and be wrong most of the time, which is fine with me. You have your own opinion. You can be wrong though, because like, he is wrong. Like all his predictions turn out to be wrong. Like and then no one ever calls him out for it for some reason. But Max will just play it safe on like everything.
Which Stephen A. calls him out for all the time.
Yep.
So,
but you can't even but you'd be like, oh, he's playing it safe. Like you can't even make fun of him. You can't even talk shit because he gave you the safe answer, which is not wrong.
What I don't like about that show, why don't they give Molly more time to talk?
She knows her shit, bro.
Jade Buckets representing the female voice.
She will roast Stephen A. sometime, bro. Yes, bro. He'll say something and be like, "Oh, you said that earlier."
Whenever
like,
she talks, damn. You ever just look at Stephen A.'s face. Like, it's as if he just doesn't want her to speak.
I literally have, a recording on my DVR right now. Randomly, I was watching the other day, and Stephen A. got, like, pissed at her. for interrupting him. She was trying to argue with him, and he was like, aren't you the moderator? You can just moderate.
Damn,
bro.
What? This man, bro.
We should watch it after this.
And she's fine as hell.
I think each man is just sexist. That's one of the things. They
always have bad bitches on First Take.
Oh, yeah. Have you guys... There's a video on Instagram today with DeMarcus Cousins. And he was talking to this reporter when he was on Sacramento.
Oh.
Did you guys see that video?
I've seen that, like,
previously. The female reporter he was talking to was, like, almost the same height as him. Which, like, I felt like it was kind of weird. Like, I was looking at it, like, no one, like... I looked at all the comments for the video and no one said anything about it. But I was looking, I kept rewatching it. Like, am I like tweaking? But like, no. He's like 7 feet tall and this bitch is standing with the microphone, like looking him like in the eyes. Like, I'm like, damn, like, she could start for the Cavs. Like, holy shit. I'm like, what? There's no one else. Like, she like 6'9, like,
to go in the NBA.
Damn. How tall are these heels? Like, is she standing on something right
I'm gonna
now?
Miss, I'm going to miss all
one,
the...
1 foot heel.
I'm going to miss all the LeBron carrying the shitty Cavs jokes I used to make.
Yeah.
Those are all as fun. Now he might have a decent team, so he can't say that as much.
Do you guys see that that Curry meme where it was like, L.A. Lakers, L.A. LeBron,
yeah.
L.A. PD, Warriors in four. Curry's got a cigarette in his mouth and his ear, too.
Bro, it had me so fucked up. After I saw LeBron go to the Lakers, I was like, hey, like, they're going to have a chance now.
And then Boogie.
I think it was real, bro. Like, I saw something that was like Boogie sign. Like, I literally just ignored it. For some, I just ignored it. I was like, this is some dumb like Twitter shit. Like, I'm not even going to read this. And like a few hours later, someone said like, something to me, and I was like, I tried to ignore them too because I was like, I didn't want to hear this right now.
If I ignore it, it's not true.
I went to the Legion NBA.
Like, nah, bro, come on.
And it's and they had all caps like DeMarcus Cousins like to the Warriors. I lost my damn mind. I just.
Well, bro.
Were you excited?
Yeah, I was excited, but I was like confused. I'm like, what? I'm like, what type of deal?
I guess if this happens,
because now you're gonna get even more valid hate because now you have the Marcus
Smith team
too.
So that's putting more
fuel to the fire.
So what I have to do is I have to go all the way back to like when I became a Warriors fan.
Yeah, tell your whole story now.
I have to tell people how this team came to be, how they drafted Curry, how they drafted Klay Thompson, how they drafted Draymond Green in the second round. I have to mention that because these idiots. How do you see Draymond Green being who he is?
They did draft all the right players, to be honest.
Yeah,
they had a pretty good team without. It's just, but like that's why people hate on the Warriors so much because like they did it right the whole time. And all of a sudden, they got like two superstars. It's kind of unfair
because they didn't have to do it.
They didn't have to do it.
They already won 73 games.
The league could have been so much more competitive. You could have seen the Thunder win one. You know, like the Rockets.
Not even anyone else win. They could still win, but it would have been more competitive to see like other teams, bro.
But end of the day, though, you got to look at it through the player's point of view. They want a ring and they want fame. Right. They want money. End of the day, if they're in a team,
I 100% would not be that way.
Are you sure though?
Yes.
Because most of these players, they started from
and
from
everyone's roasting
low,
you
like,
all the time if you don't have a ring. Like, you're on ESPN.
LeBron started lowest. Like, these players, they started with money. They didn't start with, like, your lifestyle. So, like, when they make it now, all this work to put in, they're like, we'll give it a go, but at this point, if we can't get it, fuck it. We'll join the team.
I would like David West did, like, maybe at the end of my career. But no, if I'm good and I have a chance, I would even team up with other players, but I would not go with the fucking best team. That's not fun.
Would you feel that you're good if you keep losing, though?
But doesn't it matter if I think I am competitive enough where I genuinely would think I'd be like, yeah, I actually feel like if I get the right team, I have a chance. And it would be more fun for me trying to do that than just joining the best team all of a sudden.
You have to think of it. Just think about it in a different context.
Yeah.
It's to say, like, we're all chefs here, right?
Mm-hmm.
And, like, you want to get exposure. Harden.
Would you cook for McDonald's or would you cook for fucking, like, Westin? Like,
that's a totally, because...
That's technically different, bro, because that has money.
McDonald's are getting paid minimum. Wage.
Yeah.
Dude, you're probably getting paid more.
Money's not the thing,
not
bro. It's about money.
I use that comparison,
money.
But listen, though. Like,
if money's what you care about, so, you can get more money at a different team.
Right? Yeah.
And if you're by yourself and you do something sweeter, you'd get more fame, actually, than you're on a whole ass team like that.
Okay, but what if the team you're on, though, the franchise, you're just not getting what you need in that team.
Right.
I'm just playing devil's advocate here. I'm saying, like,
I feel you.
What if you're not getting
what
you need? Like, you just notice that the franchise is ass. The owners and the coaches don't know what to do.
If I was DeMarcus and I was in his position, I probably would go to the Lakers. Lakers can pay me more. I'm playing with LeBron, and I'm probably not the best team right off the bat, but we can do it. And it would be more fun than if I had just joined the Warriors now.
All right, a part of me...
Wouldn't everyone at least agree with that?
I could agree, but in the same token, the thing about DeMarcus was injured. He went back and thought, at least January, at least.
He played with LeBron, the best player ever.
His mindset is, this first year where I'm basically injured most of the season, I pick a team with a guaranteed ring, and then I'll move to the team where I can play. What if he's doing that? What if he's literally saying...
How much better would it be if he's... started with LeBron, you can prove yourself with that team, and you could show that you're that good.
Get better in which context, though? Because better in Warriors, you try less, you get a ring. That's better as in like effort wise.
If you're next to LeBron, you could still get the fame because you could do good and you could be the second best player with someone that's really good. And if you're also really good, you guys have a chance of winning, right? On the Warriors, you're gonna win. You're gonna be the fourth, maybe the third best player, maybe the third best player.
Yeah, but what? You're gonna be the first best center in the Warriors, for sure.
Right.
And then you're missing my point. I totally get your point. I'm just like,
remember earlier when you said you might David West it at the end. DeMarcus Cousins basically just did David West it.
No, because he's like 28.
No, but like, I know he's young. That's what Tyree hates him so much for doing it now. If he was 36 and he did it, no one would hate him. But he literally took such a big pay cut as if like, oh, I can't even do it anymore. Like I just got to give up and go to like the Warriors. Like what? Like you still have a chance to beat them by yourself.
Like how you joined the best other team at Gilbert.
Yeah.
But isn't it way more fun when you have a team that doesn't seem like it was as good, but then it's just like more of like you, like it's more. That's why it's so much more fun to play with a team like full of us. Right?
Oh yeah,
as opposed to random people, and then we could win. And even when we lose close games, as opposed to winning, like we. Maybe even if we lose more games than we win, just because we won we won a good amount of games by ourselves, it still feels better than if I.
Oh yeah, well listen. How do you know DeMarcus had that relationship with his team though?
Well, it's not about the team.
It's not about the team.
I'd rather play with you guys.
He could have took six mil anywhere.
Lose 90% of my games.
Could have took 6 mil anywhere.
Then play with a team that I don't know and win every game.
Why did he go to the Warriors?
That's what, to get a ring.
Because Paul George wanted a ring.
To sign a big contract like that, Paul George must have went there because he wanted to go to the LA, and then he's probably good friends with Westbrook now. He likes being with him. Like you could. Find someone that you cool
with. I'm seeing like with DeMarcus.
You know what? That's why I respect Paul George. Because he, unlike KD, he gave it another chance. He gave another chance. He's like, you know, I'll do it again.
There's no way he didn't like Anthony Davis.
He's a promising team.
We're the only person he liked.
He gave Indiana a chance when they made it to the Eastern Conference Finals.
He's annoyed with Rondo because he went on.
Yeah, he did multiple seasons, like you said. He did give them a chance. And then he felt like this would be the best option for him.
He could resign with them, but he did. He didn't want to.
He had problems with the front office.
But that just proves my point. He didn't give them a chance.
He did give them a chance. He stayed there for so long.
He did that on his rookie deal. You know that, right?
But he was... How old is he now? Like 28?
He did that for... That first stint when he made the multiple conference finals, that was on his rookie deal.
Who?
Paul George. When he was with Indiana.
Yeah.
That was when he was on the rise.
Yeah, but still, he still had problems with the team, and the team wasn't as good. He still got LeBron there.
To make it to the East Finals. But anyway, let me just bring up what I was saying earlier. We got to think about it from a different perspective. If we're all chefs, and we want exposure to the best restaurant possible, we all would want to go to that restaurant and cook for them,
That's
right?
true. But like, cause from my experience
and,
as a chef,
and the owner of that restaurant would want the best.
That's
of the
different,
best.
Though.
That's
but Jerry, listen,
not playing head to head.
Yeah,
hold up, Jerry. And also, if you're DeMarcus Cousins, why do you want exposure? Everyone already knows you're the best center.
Lakers fan, to defend you. So as a cook, and friends with a lot of chefs. One of my chefs, he's paid $100,000 to work at a restaurant in Denmark, one of the best restaurants in the world.
Okay.
But he paid that much, right? So he's taking a pay cut. To work at one of the best restaurants, like Boogie's, they're gonna pay cut to work at one of the best teams for experience, for that title on the resume saying I worked at this place.
Right,
Boogie, I got a ring, played for the Warriors. So I, you know, in a
he's,
way,
he just wants
right.
to go down in history,
I feel you.
Bro.
I feel you.
This could be a
that
dynasty. They could win like
that
five in a row.
Yeah.
They could win like five in a row.
That could make sense. Yeah,
they're all saying fuck it, like.
Yeah. Because
at the end of the day, who wins it?
Yeah.
It's about who wins
it,
you know?
It's whatever goes down in the history books.
Yeah.
They're gonna
because 10 years from now, no one's going to look back at KD and be
like, look at this
exactly.
And be
like, oh, KD
yeah.
was sweet.
Yeah.
No one's going to be like, oh, he was the bitch because he left OKC.
Look how dominant this team was.
They'd be like, who's OKC? They'd be like, the Warriors.
Well, they're probably still down with
those. Yeah, but I was saying, like,
yeah, you just
be like,
their main goal is to not be forgotten.
Yeah.
And this team If it does what it's supposed to, you will not forget about any of it. Because you're gonna see it on a nightly basis.
Oh no! At this point, Warriors are in the history books. This point.
And if you're on that team or you're a Warriors fan or you live there, no, if you live there and you're on the team, then it probably feels pretty good.
Oh hell yeah!
They beat LeBron.
They beat LeBron's ass team.
Three times.
Whatever, Jared.
Alright.
They still threw a 3-1 lead. And he still dropped 51 on them the first game because of JR. They lost because of JR. They should have been up 1-0, too. Like,
I mean, JR was on the Henny, so we know what happened.
He was a more Henny Jay. Henny. He was on edibles.
Don't say they beat LeBron. They beat the Cavs, bro.
Before we end this, we should all take a hit.
But they beat the Cavs with LeBron. Like, who did most of the work for the Cavs and brought them there?
They basically beat LeBron.
No.
Other water.
Oh, no, I don't. Right, you can hit. I'll just take a little sip of this, that's all.
Of the tonic?
Yeah, the tonic.
The chronic.
Chronic.
The second episode.
All right, I think we're going to wrap this last episode up. All right,
guys, stay toasty.
Stay toasty.
Stay lit.
Keep rolling those fat doinks.
Happy 4th of July Eve.
Happy 4th of July.
Happy
4th of July to the Warriors, I guess.
To the NBA. Most importantly, happy birthday to D-Wade and the Heat.
Sure.
That's my team.
You can bleep this one out. Still sucking on Dwayne Wade.
He's just sucking on LeBron's dick.
Alright, for the second podcast, we're signing out.
Hey, NBA's canceled next year.
Blackout Part 2.